Got a new bag of goodies from China. In a previous video when I was talking about trees, I mentioned that I had another batch coming from another cheap overseas vendor, and here they are. Let's see what these ones look like. Actually, let's throw this bag out here. No, let's clean up my workbench. Jump cut. There, that's much more reasonable. Now then, back to these trees. Let's dump them out here and see what we've got. Oh, lots of loose ground foam. Okay. Oh, a couple of different sizes in this bunch. That's nice. I was worried that they were going to be similar to some that I already have. That one's got some blobbiness on it. So, looks like, oh, and they're not even symmetrical, that's good, because, you know, real trees aren't. So, looks like two different sizes. Looks like there's these guys here, which are, what is that? That is 7 centimeters for the full trunk to tip, or... For you old school people, 2.5 inches, give or take. Let's go a little bit more close up at this. Let's turn my lens around so I can actually see what I'm doing here. Yep, that's better. Okay. Focusing. Okay. There. That's not too bad. There's a bit of bark detail on the trunk. Pretty good. So a couple others of that same size there. Yeah, there's a few gaps in the branches on some of them, but not too horrible actually. Now then, excuse me, there's just a couple. This one here's got an ugly little glue blob on it. It looks like it'll come off fairly easily with a careful application of some tweezage. Oh yeah, that was easy. There, improved it a whole bunch. It's slightly bent. No, it's not. That's not bad. Okay. Those guys look coming to the light. Oh, there's actually 3 sizes. Check that out. Out of the way. Okay, so we measured the little guys. How much? That one is 3 3/4 in old school, or 9.5 centimeters for the modern world. And this guy, bent or not, what's that? 11.5 or 12 centimeters. 4.5 inches. That's excellent. So that was a package of 20 trees. I'll overlay the cost of them. The Amazon page that I bought these from, they work out to about 35 cents a tree, which is excellent value, I think. Especially considering what your average North American hobby shop would charge. Wow, that's sparse and beat up looking. Let's get in here. Refocus. Hello, there we go. That's pretty ugly, actually. However, in the background, an ugly, you know, tree with ugly branches like that isn't out of place. Plus, I'll probably take some of this ground foam here and add it on. With a bit of hairspray or other cheap spray adhesive. That's not too bad. Haven't been burned yet. Let's see what some of these look like in the layout. Alright, here we are over at our little test plot that I planted in the last video. With the 2 different types of trees that I got previously from 2 different vendors. So it's a slightly different color and different shape than both of them. That's excellent. So let's do a bit of planting. You in there. You little guy down in front. Actually, he can even be shorter down there. And you other sized one, kind of there. With the wind blowing, look. And that one, I'll push down a little bit further. Because that one is actually shorter than this one. Well, that looks alrighty. Getting some variety. The ground foam on these ones, and actually these ones too, is a little bit actually glisteny. These ones are nice and matte. These ones I might have to do something, and these ones, these darker ones too. Oops, sorry, kicked the tripod. Might have to do something to dull them down a little bit. But there's the two new ones. That one and that one. That's one of the previous ones back there. Colors on them look a little bit different to the camera. Actually, zooming out a bit more helps. In real life, these ones don't look quite as bright yellowish in them, I don't know. And the darkness between these two doesn't look quite as stark in real life as it does on the camera. Now that might be because there's a shadow on this one from this one. Let's change the lighting a little bit. Like I said, it doesn't look as drastic in real life as it does on camera. That's okay, because I'm going to be looking at it in real life 90% of the time. Where they're a little bit shiny. Not thrilled like that. Trees aren't supposed to be shiny. So, dull coat. And it's basically clear paint. Clear matte finish spray paint. And there are other brands of it. But this is the one that I happen to have. Now then. Had I been thinking, would have had some kind of a holder. Maybe that'll do. Now what do I do with the other two? One of them can sit in that hole. Okay. And now we wait for them to dry. Time has passed. Let's see what these guys look like. There's a before and there's an after. That one's got the dull coat on it, that one doesn't. Well, let's knock some of the glisteny plasticiness off. There's another random one. Oh yeah, look at that. There's the dull-coated one. I think that's a lot less glisteny. Like that. And Papa Tree, Mama Tree, BB Tree. And dull-coated, not dull-coated. Yep, I think that's a wiener. Anyway, there's Cheap Chinese Trees Part 2. I'm sure there will be more to come.